morning. My name is Father Terry Grachanin, parochial vicar at St. Charles Borromeo Parish in Parma. That's right in Ohio. I don't know if any of you would like to remember me. I did come to my first vocation talk 8 or 9 years ago, I believe in January of 06. And I remember thinking at that time, when we came back to giving all our talks every Mass where we had gone, I said, I was at Our Lady of outside of Ohio. I couldn't believe how far I never thought I'd be back here. I'm most happy to be with you this morning, and I thank everyone for the great hospitality already in such a short amount of time. Let us begin our prayers as we walk through, with that sign traced upon our forehead at the time of our baptism. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us pause for a moment and call to mind our sin, so that we might be worthy to celebrate these sacred feasts.
Lord Jesus, you came together in the nation, and into the peace of God, Lord, have
mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Thank you. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, master of the palace. I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day, I will summon my servant, Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash and give over to him your authority. He shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one shall open. I will fix him like a peg in a sure spot, to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart. For you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. I will give thanks to your name because of your kindness and your truth. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. The Lord is exalted, yet the lowly he sees, and the proud he knows from afar. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God. How inscrutable are his judgments and how unsearchable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor? Or who has given the Lord anything that he may be repaid? For from him, and through him, and for him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it.
This weekend's gospel begins in a somewhat unusual way. It starts with a statement about geography, about a particular location way north in Galilee called Caesarea Philippi. This city contained one of the most prominent landmarks in all of Israel. It was built on a massive wall of rock over 100 feet high and 500 feet wide. There, a marble temple had been erected to honor Caesar, who considered himself to be a god. And through the years, hundreds of people would have traveled to this spot to carve niches into the side of this enormous cliff, place statues of their pagan gods into them, and worship them. So now, knowing this, perhaps you can begin to see why it was that Jesus took his disciples some 25 miles out of their way, all on foot, for the sole purpose of asking them a single question. So it was with great intent that he wanted the backdrop of massive rock, a marble temple, and all the honors given to the emperors and their gods, when he asks a question that is quite possibly the most important one in all of the Gospels. Who do people say I am? That same question, of course, was not only addressed to his first followers thousands of years ago, but it has echoed down throughout the centuries until it lands upon the ears of those living today. Who do people say that I am? That same question, however, is really no longer about Jesus, but about us. Who am I? What do I believe? What do I stand for? Where does North point on my compass? And what statue would I place in the niche on the side of the cliff of my life? Because let's face it, you and I are no different than those first disciples. I think we have all kinds of answers to the question of who Jesus is. I think every one of us can find a way to clothe Jesus in our himself, to project onto him our own wishes, our own aspirations, and our own self-interests. To put it very simply another way, we can find very easily ways of reshaping Christ to best suit our purposes. Simon, son of Jonah, who stood there with his back to this massive wall of rock, who will end up denying him 3 times, who always doesn't understand so many things, this same Simon is given a new name, Peter, the Rock. And that's what can happen for each one of us. Jesus can make new openings in our lives, break the molds that we've shaped for ourselves, draw us toward new realizations, and fashion new understandings. Jesus can rename us if we allow it. If we allow it, Jesus can create within each of us a great passion for justice, a justice that will shape our certainties, our privileges, and our self-interests. If we allow it, Jesus can construct within each of us a great tenderness that puts our pettiness to shame, and an experience of freedom that will release us from all our enslavement. Our enslavement to sin and our tendency toward sin. All that weighs us down. That one thing we struggle with time and again. Jesus can transform it, but only if we allow it. Who do you say that I am? All too often, we answer very easily that Jesus is our God, even when he is not at the center of our lives. All too often, we answer him quite easily that we confess Jesus to be our Lord, even when we live with our backs turned to his great project, his great ministry of both forgiveness and mercy. And all too often, we answer easily that he is our teacher when we sometimes barely listen to his lessons. In the end, we will all have to face the wall of Caesarea Philippi and honestly answer that single gospel question. Who do people say that I am? So how will you decide to answer? My brothers and sisters, we have shared God's word, and now let's profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things. God for his wisdom that is beyond our understanding. But we can ask him for all our needs because he shares his wisdom with us and uses us for his purpose.
For our Pope, Francis, successor of St. Peter, that he may use the power of the keys wisely, according to God's plan, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who accept the burden of public office, that the powers of evil may not prevail over them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those living with disabilities, that they may not be pushed aside, overlooked, or underestimated, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves, that we may reverence the power of the keys which God entrusts in his wisdom to the pastors of his church, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, especially Barbara Spisak and Annie Culinary, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all who have died, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, source of all wisdom, your Son entrusted his power to his church. As we offer these prayers, help us to fulfill your plan for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Second collection today is for Faith and Values Education.
Our hymn for the presentation of the gifts can be found in your missalette, number 249.
Thank you.
fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself. But the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with them in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim.
the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, fill not our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity, in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
Please join in singing Alleluia, Sing to Jesus. In your missalettes, number 322.
Thank you.
Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to kindly be seated for this moment. Thank you again for your great hospitality. I understand it's very common that confessions are often heard at this liturgy, and I am available. I'll be in the back portal. And hopefully I will return one day to the border of Pennsylvania. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God's blessing sends us forth in your missalettes, number 364.